Hello. So now we are going to do the trim function, which is a part of the text functions. Now we have done a number of text functions. Just for a recap, we have done the find and the search. So you can find a particular string or a text in another string or some word. Then we have the left and the right. So if you want to get some numbers or some letters from a particular string from the left hand side of a string or from the right hand side of the string, so you use these functions. Then we have also studied about the lower, upper and proper. So the lower, what lower does is it basically changes all the strings to small letters. Upper does the opposite, it changes in caps, and proper, it changes all the first letters of all the words into a capital. Then we have done something as the len function, which gives us the length of the entire word. We have also done the mid function. In this you can get it's like in the left and the right, we get words from the left and from the right, and in the mid you can take out any string from the middle of a word. So you give the starting position and the number of, see, you give the starting position, which is the start number. So my start number is 6, and you give the last, so I'll just, and you give the last, and you give the number of characters you want. So I want to start from the 6th position, which is 0, and I want to take out these two letters, these two numbers, so I just write a 2, so the number of characters is 2. So these were the basic functions which we have done for the text functions. Now we have also one function called the trim function. So in trim function, what happens, it removes all the spaces. Now we take data, we gather data from many places. Now suppose you are in a particular department and you want data from maybe 4-5 other departments. So what happens, it depends that it might so happen that the record keeping of those 4-5 departments may not match, or it might so happen that you can see I've made a table. So I'll use pivot tables and explain you all. I've used various names over here. Now I'll explain the difference between the names, why this Shivangi and this Shivangi are different. So when I double click over here, you can see there is one space added over here, and when I double click over here, there is no space. Similarly in Praveen, there is no space. Over here we have two spaces, actuators no space, Mehul no space. So basically what do I want to state you all is that there is a difference between this Shivangi and this Shivangi because of the spaces, and this might lead to certain errors. So we'll remove all the spaces in our data using the trim function. Now I'll just give you a small example. I'll just select this and I'll insert a pivot table. So I'll So this is my pivot table which I have created over here. Now I'll just take this names to the row labels. So these are the names which we have, and the counts. So just one thing for you all to see is that I have 6 counts. I wanted Shivangi to have a count of 2. I wanted Praveen to have a count of 2, but it's showing me separately, like this Praveen and this Praveen are different. This Shivangi and this Shivangi are being taken as a different elements by the Excel, which is not the case, which is not the case in the real world. I want this to be a single Shivangi, and I want the count to be 2, because Shivangi has appeared twice, Praveen has appeared twice. I want this to happen. Now how do you do that? I go to the text again, my sheet, and over here what do I do is I use the trim function. Now the trim function, it removes all the spaces from the text string except for the single spaces between the words. So what happens that if you have a word, I'll just give you an example for that. Before that, I'll just select this word. Okay. So I'll just select this word over here. And now you can see this had 2 spaces around, but this Shivangi will have no space in it. So I'll just drag this down, and now have filled all of these. So what I can do now is these are the words without any spaces. So I'll just copy and I'll paste these here. So I'm not going to paste the formulas because these contains the trim formulas. So I'm not going to paste the trim formulas. Instead, I'm going to paste the values only. So I'll just go to the paste special, and over here I'll just paste the values instead. So I've pasted the values. You can come back over here and see it's a value, it's not a formula. Over here it's a formula, and here it's a normal Shivangi which is there, it's not a formula. So I'll just double click and see the spaces are gone. Spaces are gone. See, this is how we use the trim function. Now suppose if you have a word, let's say suppose I have Shivangi and I have 5 spaces, 4 to 5 spaces, and then I have Agarwal. So what trim function will do is that it will remove all the spaces except the single space. So see, it removed all the spaces from the left, it removes all the spaces from the left, from the right, and also from between the words. It removes all the spaces and keeps only a single space. So that is the major use of the trim function. Now we'll just go to the sheet one of our pivot table, and I'll just refresh this. And so now you can see we have Praveen as a count of 2, Shivangi as a count of 2. So this means that now both the Shivangis are being taken as 1, because as we remove the spaces. So you can see the significance of having spaces and not having the spaces, and it can lead to major errors, because here you can see it's a very small data, but when you're dealing with large and large of tons of data, thousands of records, then it becomes very difficult for you all to match the results. So in that case, what do you do? You try to use the trim function so that it removes all your spaces, unwanted spaces. Now we'll do same thing using for the VLOOKUP. So I'll be using the trim function, and I'm going to show you all that how it affects the VLOOKUP as well. So basically I have a few examples in this. I have a few names and the math marks given, and I have few names written over here for which I need the math marks using the VLOOKUP. So see, I've added a few spaces in this. Priya hasn't any space over here, does not have any space here. Okay, so Priya has, I guess, 2-3 spaces. Anush has spaces. So I've added a spaces on purpose to show you all that how this also affects the VLOOKUP. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to write VLOOKUP, and I'm just going to select this as my VLOOKUP value. Then I'm going to select this as my table array, and I'm just going to absolute, make this absolute, both of these, clicking on F4, just by clicking on F4. And then we have this column index number, which is 2 obviously, and then a 0 for the exact match. So I'll just click on OK, and I'll just click on enter, and you get the value, and you get an error as the NA. Though I have Priya over here, but still I'm getting this error because the value is not available. The value of Priya is not available over here according to Excel, and so Excel is not able to complete the lookup. The match cannot find the proper match of Priya, because here Priya has spaces as you can see, but here Priya is without the spaces. So now what do I do is in the VLOOKUP itself, I'll use the trim function. So in this only I'll use the trim function, and now see, I got the value as 76. So this is how you work out, and similarly I'll drag it and I get the value of all of these. If you remove the trim again, then again you'll see that you face the difficulty, you don't get the value, you get an error. So this is how you use the trim function within the VLOOKUP as well, because always remember, in Excel, first of all, it's case sensitive most of the times, and the second of all that it considers the spaces. Okay, so even if you have more than one space, suppose here if you have Priya one space, then it's an exact match. But even if you have one extra space, it won't give you a perfect match. But this is a very, very common issue which you can face in your work life. Why? Because you get data from many resources, many places. And maybe you are in a sales department and you have got a report from various from your various reporters basically. So then what do you do is that maybe it so happened that the reporters and other sales staff, maybe they have recorded the data and by mistake added a few extra spaces. It might so happen also when you are writing double name like Shivangi Agarwal, so you might so happen that you add maybe more than one space. So in those times, trim function is very helpful. Now again, I'll show you one more last example of VLOOKUP using the trim, but now there is a, it's a complete interchange of this. In here, I have, over here, I don't have any spaces in my lookup values, but I have spaces in my actual table. So as you can see, I have spaces in here. See, so I have added spaces over here in my actual table, whereas I have no spaces added in the lookup values. So in that case also, what we'll do is, in that case also, let us find we get any error or not. So is this, this is my lookup value. Then this entire table is my table array. I'll just click on F4, and to make it absolute, column index number is 2 and 0 for exact match. So again, you get this NA, which is, it's not applicable. You can't find Priya over here because here Priya is, doesn't have any spaces. Here Priya has 2-3 spaces. So now again, what do we do is we use the trim function, but now for the entire VLOOKUP instead of only a single value. Why so? Because your trim, you need to trim the entire table. You need to trim the entire column basically. That's not possible because when you're selecting, one thing which you can obviously do is you can copy paste this. You can use trim function in this very column as we did for the pivot table, wherein I created a one more column. I used the trim function and I copy pasted the names over here as values. So similarly, you can do this, but to save your time, you can use the trim function with the VLOOKUP. And when you use trim outside of the VLOOKUP, and basically we are using VLOOKUP within the trim function, so basically you are trying to trim the entire table. So that becomes very easier. I'll click on enter and still I get a NA. Now why do I get a NA? Because remember that this is a table. And when you are dealing with a table and you are using a function for the entire table, then it's not only a range function. It becomes a matrix function, because this, or an array function, because this is no longer a single range, a single column range or a single row range, but this is now a table you are dealing with. So whenever you're dealing with a table, we'll do something like frequency and the offset function. So those are as well the what do you say is matrix or the array functions. In those cases, what do is that you don't hit enter straight away. You hit control shift enter, and the moment so we I'm so sorry, we don't use the trim function over here. Instead, we use the trim function with the entire table. So we use the trim function with the entire table. So basically what I'm trying to do is, I'm trying to trim my table, I'm trying to trim my column, this particular column, in order to find the exact match of Priya, and I want to find the math marks. So I need to trim not my VLOOKUP value, or the lookup value. If you need to trim the lookup value, you may simply use the trim function over here as we did in our earlier example. Or when you want to use the trim for the entire table, then you might, then you can use the trim function with the entire table as well. Now, one more thing which I need to tell you all, that I am using trim with the entire table. So this again is a matrix function, as I explained. It is not a basic function, because anything you use with an entire table becomes a, which changes your entire table basically. So this is going to change your entire table. So when this happens, then it basically becomes a matrix function, and you have to, or an array function, and you have to not just click on enter, you don't get the value there. Then what do you have to do is, so then what do you have to do? You just have to simply, you just can't click on enter, you get the value error. You have to click you have to press Control Shift Enter. And the moment you click on Control Shift Enter, you get the answer. You can simply copy this down and you get the values. See, there is one difference which I have explained. Control Shift Enter is that you can see in the formula function is that we have in the formula bar, you can just simply see that we have curly brackets. This curly bracket signifies that it's a matrix function which you have used. Now, one more thing which you might notice is that when I used trim function over here and I used it to trim the lookup value instead of the table, here I have used trim function to trim the table. I have used the trim function to trim the table and then get my VLOOKUP answer. Control Shift Enter. As you can see, these are right aligned and these are left aligned. Now, what is the difference? Generally, the numericals are always, basically always the numericals are right aligned until you format it in a particular way, and the text strings are left aligned. So now, as you have used the trim function for the entire table itself, then this becomes a text function. Text, basically the answer you get it becomes a text. So because you have trimmed the entire table, if you have any spaces over in the numbers or any such, it trims everything and then you get the answer. So it's now not a numeric answer which you are getting, it's a text string or the text answer which you are getting. Now you can just simply go to the format home tab and you can change it to number if you want to, but then I'm leaving it to be general in this case. So this has changed the number to a text when you use the trim with the entire table. So this is how you work out. Please do not click on enter, click on Control Shift Enter. So I've explained three things using the trim. One was the pivot table, basically to explain you all that it considers, Excel considers the difference between spaces, and also with the VLOOKUP function where the lookup values had spaces and where you had spaces within the table itself. And it might so happen that you need to use trim for both, maybe the VLOOKUP, the lookup values. So you need to use trim within the lookup value and as well as the table, both. So it might so happen that you might need to use trim for the both. So this is how we use the trim function, very vastly, very widely used. Thank you.